that biologic and immunomodulators. The immunoglobulin, first one is hyperimmunoglobulin. This hyperimmunoglobulin is specific for, it is used to treat the three types of infection. It is used to treat hepatitis B infection. It is used to treat varicella zoster infection. It is used to treat rabies infection. So this immunoglobulin is like in the immunoglobulin, we use hyperimmunoglobulin. This hyperimmunoglobulin, it is specific for the treatment of hepatitis B, varicella zoster, and rabies infection. Next is monoclonal antibody. Name the monoclonal antibody which is used to treat the viral infection. Answer is palivizumab. Palivizumab is the monoclonal antibody that is used to treat the viral infections. The monoclonal antibody, it is used to treat, it is a glycoprotein. It is directed against a glycoprotein on the surface. We have said that viral, on our top part of the virus, we have some antigenic glycoprotein, I have said. It will go and bind to the surface of respiratory syncytial virus, and it will kill that virus. So that means, name the monoclonal antibody which is used to treat respiratory syncytial virus infection. Answer is palivizumab is to treat respiratory syncytial virus infection. Next one, when it is given in the form of intramuscular injection, when it is also given in the form of IM, that means intramuscular injection, to prevent the infection by respiratory syncytial virus infection. So simply, this the monoclonal antibody used to prevent the respiratory syncytial virus infection. Next, coming to the interferon. We have the interferon, different interferon alpha, interferon beta, interferon gamma. So the interferon gamma is termed as immune interferon. Which of the interferon is termed as immune interferon? Interferon gamma. So this interferon gamma is produced by, interferon gamma is produced by T lymphocytes. It is produced by T lymphocytes. And interferon alpha and beta, these are produced by B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes, macrophages and fibroblasts. So interferon alpha and beta, both are produced by B lymphocytes, T lymphocytes, macrophages and fibroblasts. And only the interferon gamma is produced by T lymphocytes. Interferon gamma is called as immune interferon. Now, when you look at, we have subtypes. In interferons, we have interferon alpha 2A and we have interferon alpha 2B. So, interferon alpha 2A, it is used to treat hepatitis B infection. Hepatitis B infection. Interferon alpha 2A is used to treat hepatitis B infection. And we have another interferon called as interferon alpha 2B. And it is also used, interferon alpha 2A used to treat hepatitis B infection and AIDS related Kaposi's sarcoma infection. Name the interferon which is used to treat the AIDS related Kaposi's sarcoma infection and hepatitis B infection. Answer is interferon alpha 2A. Next we have interferon alpha 2B. It is used to treat hepatitis C infection. Now, we have another interferon called as pegylated interferon. What is meant by pegylated interferon? The interferon which is conjugated with polyethylene glycol, we call it as pegylated interferon. The interferon which is conjugated with polyethylene glycol is called as pegylated interferon, and it is having the longer T-off. It is having the longer T-off. The interferon which is conjugated with the polyethylene, when it is conjugated with polyethylene glycol, it will have long circulating T-off. That means it will stay in the plasma for the longer time. And the unwanted effect of this pegylated interferon are, it causes fever, it causes some type of dizziness feeling, lazy. The lazy feeling is called as lassitude. And it causes the muscle pain, that is called as myalgia. It causes the muscle pain called as myalgia. The unwanted effects are fever, lassitude, myalgia, M-Y-A-L-I-G-A, myalgia, and repeated injection will cause chronic malaise. What is meant by malaise? That means discomfort. On the repeated information, it causes chronic malaise and headache is a common. So it causes fever, lassitude, myalgia. Repeated injection causes chronic malaise, that means discomfort feeling. And it is also caused bone marrow depression, has a side effect. This pegylated interferon will also cause the bone marrow depression has a side effect. And it causes rashes. It causes rashes and it causes alopecia. Alopecia means it causes reversible hair loss. And it is also, it causes some disturbances in, it causes cardiovascular disturbances, thyroid disturbances and hepatic disturbances. That means the bone marrow depression, rashes, alopecia, disturbances in cardiovascular, thyroid and hepatic dysfunction, fever, lassitude, myalgia, headache and repeated administration, it causes myalgic feeling. And this is all about the interferons. And pimavanserin is what is used to treat respiratory syncytial virus infection. Hyperimmunoglobulin is used to treat hepatitis B, varicella zoster and rabies infection.